after being here all this time, if there was one thing that you were going to tell me that we need to get better, what would it be?
Tough question, but I think we can have a private conversation with
you. Okay. When it's not scripted, I would literally stop somebody in the hallway and introduce myself. I ask them where they work. I ask them how long they've been here. If they're in a unit that I haven't heard of, I will say, well, can I walk to your office with you? It always makes people nervous. Good morning. How you doing? Good to see you. You don't have to get to the side. Hi, I'm Eugene Washington. Good morning.
Good morning.
Hi. Hi. Chance Washington. How you doing?
I'm good.
I do feel I'm fortunate that I like people. I have this appreciation for the contributions that every individual has the potential to make.
Since I've been here, whenever I want to come and get the truth about something that's going on, I come down.
And the best way for me to carry out my role of representing the people was to know them.
I don't know a single soul who didn't like Gene. He's a cheerleader and a mentor and a believer.
I was always drawn to this notion of having impact on a broader scale. What I do goes beyond the white coat. Making well means more than just making sure that the acute illness is treated. It's about the ability to really partner with others to address the broader determinants of health. There is something called Healthy Durham 2020. This is a movement, as we are calling it. We feel that working, addressing the environmental factors, the socioeconomic factors, the mental health factors, that we actually can move the needle and measurably improve the health of citizens in Durham, in the city, and in county.
We will learn from you, which is where it should be. It's always a bilateral exchange. From a patient perspective, what are the things that we can do beyond making a diagnosis and giving the medicine to help improve the overall health?
As stressful as the whole healthcare environment is, there's a real feeling of optimism that we can change the world. And I'll have to say, it's people like Gene Washington who are the kind of people that exemplify the very best of what UCSF is about.
UCSF, at the time that I applied to medical school, had the most underrepresented minorities of any medical school in the U.S. outside of Howard University, where I had been an undergraduate school. There was an explicit interest in creating a diverse community, which was very attractive to me. There were few medical schools that would have allowed me the kind of flexibility that UCSF did, including arranging for me to take the year to go to Berkeley to pursue my broader interest in public health and health services and health policy. I spent early years after returning at San Francisco General providing clinical care, delivering babies and operating and building this research center focused on healthcare disparities. I went from one administrative leadership role to another, while also still maintaining a pretty full clinical practice.
I would define the vice chancellor as the chief operating officer of the campus. You know, you could be a caretaker or you could be an activist. And I think Gene was an activist. He created a group of people who were motivated even more to work on behalf of the university as a whole, as opposed to just their own units.
Gene was the first person to ever lead a strategic plan for the entire campus of UCSF. What he put an emphasis on is, how do we all think about ourselves working together? That's really built on the culture here at UCSF and taken it to another level. And frankly, you don't see that culture at very many other universities.
Very important lesson that I took from UCSF, taking risk and believing that if you are pursuing the right mission and you believe that you can achieve it. I envision a future in 10 years where we will be placing as much emphasis on promoting the health of those who are in our care as we are on curing the illnesses that present to our clinics and our hospitals. My most significant mentor is Marie, is my wife. She is my staunchest critic. She is the person that I trust most. She is the person who has always delivered.
So here we've got our wedding photo. We were married in 1982, which means we're coming up on our
36 next Tuesday.
36th anniversary. Look at how young we looked.
I'm proud of the people that I believe I have influenced and whose lives I have helped shape over the years. Students, residents, fellows, junior faculty, senior faculty, but other individuals that I've encountered, I see all of these individuals as multipliers. I'd like to believe that I've served as a model, being driven by this notion of it's not about me, it's really about what we can do for those in greatest need.